Okay, so we're almost ready to start. We have all the stuff laid out on the table here. We are missing a piston. I took it to the engineering obviously to have the new pistons fitted, and as you can see it has this in marking at the top for the intake valves, and they actually put the rod on the wrong way. So you can see this little oil squirt here, it's built into the rod, and on one piston this was facing that way. So I took it back to them. They actually doing it for free, and they already finished it, but I wasn't in time to go pick it up on Friday, so I'll probably get it on Monday. But I do still have a few things to do. I have to clean up the camshaft that's been sitting in storage for quite a while. It is in very good condition though. Luckily here we have the block ready to go as well, 0.5 oversize. I guess I have to clean these head stud holes here. I'm using this Shield engine cleaner super degreaser. Now, this stuff's not really expensive, but you do go through it very quickly, so I won't recommend cleaning everything with this. I'm just going to do some of the parts with this, like the bolts and these holes. So I'm just filling them. I also cleaned all the studs very nicely, so clean all the threads on these, because it is quite important. If you have dirt and stuff in here, it could damage the threads. These actually look very good so far, but I haven't really checked them all that nicely. But then again, this engine I did take it apart myself, and it didn't look like it had any issues with this. So yeah, let me get started on this job next, cleaning up all these bolts. That's been sitting in this bucket for about 3 years now. Cleaned up this block probably 3 or 4 times, and I just found something within this oil drain breather channel. Basically the engineering shop who skimmed the surface didn't clean it up afterwards, so you have all this aluminium material which will very likely drain down with the oil, and this could kill your engine. I really do think I need to get a new engineering shop. Okay, so this is the rings and bearings I got. I'm hoping these are the mains, because I know this is a good brand. It's not sure where it's made. Oh, it says made in Israel. I did not expect that. Anyway, I know this is a good part. Now these are NDC. Oh, made in Japan. So, you know, you just know that's a good part as well. These are the main bearings, I think. These are the thrust. Yeah, engine thrust washers. And they don't say where this stuff's made. But you know, just telling from the box, this looks a bit probably made in China. Anyway, this box looks nice. RIK. Oh, it's also saying Japan, that's good. It's also saying Taiwan. I bet it's made in Taiwan then. But yeah, I'm sure this is also a good part. Looks good. Has this little quality sticker. Okay, so next I'm gonna have to have the block here. I'm gonna have to put the bearings in, drop the crank in, bolt down the girdle. Okay, so one thing very important not to forget is to put in these thrust washers. These grooves always face outwards, so they can basically trap oil in here and keep this area lubricated. So these ones face the crank. So they face the crank. I would recommend putting some oil on this surface, but not on the surface at the back. You can see they fit flush with whatever these things are. And then obviously when you put the girdle on here, it'll keep them in place. Okay, so the crank is in, it's bolted down. It's not torqued, I just bolted it down by hand. And checking if it spins freely, very much so. I can spin it with two fingers. I know it's not torqued down all the way yet. I did put a lot of oil on this bearings, but you know, this kind of means that bearing sizes are correct. You can see there's no gap, no play. Is not to mix up the caps. The rod and the cap always goes together, always goes in the same rotation, meaning those two things are on the same side, two notches. And then make sure that when you place the bearing in there, you line this hole up with that hole, otherwise you'll block this wheel squirter and you could have premature engine failure because of that. So I fitted the piston at exactly top dead center, and as you guys can see, it's actually poking out of the block ever so slightly, like very, that's probably, I would say, half a millimeter sticking out of the block. Now that's, you know, normally not a problem. So I have the piston in here, but there is obviously no rings on the piston itself, so it's floating very freely. But I mean, look how easily everything turns. Now I googled it and once again came up with very mixed results. So what I'm going to do is just take an average in between and go with that. Some nicely packaged individually. There's some instructions. I'm just going to go with what the internet said, and they said I think 20 for the 18 for the top ring, 20 for the bottom ring. So I'm just going to go with that. Now I'm not going to pretend to be some expert because I'm not. I'm sure most of us know how to do that, or how to do this. Now this is a newly bored block, 5.5 millimeters oversize. There you can see you have the gap. So this is the top ring. The top ring is the one they said should be 18. Can't see this stuff. Obviously it has to be more than normal because of the fact that this engine is going to be turbocharged, and it can't even go in there, not even close. So this one definitely has to be gapped correctly, and I'm sure it's going to go for all of them. This was the most tedious thing ever to do, but I believe we are done now. So the sizes is 020 and 018. And that's what I got on the internet. Was some conflicting reports, but they were all around that size, so we're going with that. I've actually already done all the other ones, so I'm just going to put these on the pistons, and then we're ready to fit the pistons.